Hello and welcome to a new video. I should not have started like that, but hey, it's okay. Welcome to the German Imperial Soldier. Today I will be doing something a little bit interesting. I'm going to be starting a new series. I don't have a name for it yet, but I can explain it a little bit. In this series, I will be making ships in a game called Ultimate Admiral Dreadnought using the year 1950. This is going to be mostly a battleship comparison for the start. And I will be going to a game called World of Warships, looking at the ships there, and making the ships in Ultimate Admiral Dreadnoughts. Today, we have two ships that I do find very interesting, as they both serve as the start of a new design for these two nations, but were never fully built. Now, the ships in question are the Giuseppe Verdi, a tier 9 premium in World of Warships for Italy. In the second ship is the H-class battleship known as Friedrich der Große. Now, this ship is the H-39 class. I will be using the hit points as the weight. So, for the Friedrich der Große, it's 72,500 HP, and for the Giuseppe Verdi, it's 69,100. 69. Anyways, we will be doing three distances. We will be starting at a short range distance of 5,000 meters, going up to 10,000, finally capping off at 20,000 meters. Because if I go anything further than that, like 50,000 meters, it will be too long of a battle to start. So, I will be designing these ships in front of you guys. I'll be talking to you a little bit about these ships from what I know. Now, I don't know as much as I wish, but it should be good enough. So I'll name the ship the Friedrich. I'm probably spelling that wrong. No, I got it. Der Große. And then that's gonna be that name. I'm gonna switch the other name later. Post-production soldier here. There is seemed to be a mix-up with the audio, so I am here to basically say what I was saying in the video. So the Friedrich der Große was a H-class series of battleship. Specifically the H-39. Now, if you actually look at the design for the H-39, the actual weight that it was supposed to be was 56,444 tons. Now, if you look at the HP in World of Warships, it's much higher than that. The reason I'm using the HP or the health pool from World of Warships in this game is because it makes the transfer from World of Warships to Ultimate Admiral Dreadnoughts a lot easier. The main guns are 40.6 centimeter main guns, secondary guns are 15 centimeter and 10.5 centimeter, AA guns are 3.7 centimeter and 2 centimeter guns. Now, a little bit about the Friedrich der Große or the H-class series of battleships. They initially were supposed to be 35 centimeter guns. Fun fact, the Bismarck was the earliest design study for the Schlachtschiff H, or battleship H. The Bismarck was supposed to have 35 centimeter guns, but they switched it to 38 once they heard of the Soviets planning to build the Sovetsky Suvoi class. After the Bismarck's construction, design, and all that stuff, in 1937, when it was already laid down and started production, the H-39 begun its drawing phase. The H-39, 40.6 centimeter guns, as mentioned before. Now, the H-class series of battleship has five types of battleships: the 39, the 41, 42, 43, and the 44. The 39 means that that's the day that it's supposed to start building. But after the war didn't turn their way, they decided to scrap that and cancel all of that, so it just stopped. The H-39 and H-41 are pretty much the only battleships of this series of proposals that were actually competent, I should say, because once you get to the H-42 to H-44, the main guns are absurd. 48 centimeter guns and 50.8 centimeter guns. For those who don't know centimeters, it's 18.9 inches and 20 inches for main guns, which is crazy and would not survive in the water, which is why I'm saying that the H-39 and the H-41, which have guns 40.6 centimeter and 42 centimeter, were more more plausible than the 42 to 44. Now, as the war got on, most likely these designers wanted to keep their jobs and not go onto the Eastern Front, so that is why they kept designing that ship in this way.
Now, I'm coming on to finishing the Frigida Grossa, and we will move on to the next ship very soon.
So, this is my design for the Große... I keep saying Große Code first, I apologize. This is my design for the Frigida Grossa. I'm going to scroll down just in case. And then we can now move on to the Italian battleship, Giuseppe Verdi. Now, the initial design for this was the UP-41 project. Let me put Giuseppe Verdi, the composer. The initial design, like I said, was the UP-41. This is pretty much a... This does not look... I have the Japanese. There we go. Now we have the Italians versus the Germans. So, going back to this, the Giuseppe Verdi was the UP-41 project. The UP-41 was pretty much a Littorio-class battleship, but a little bit more on the heftier side.
Post-production soldier here again. And yes, it's not going to be the first time you're going to hear this post-production again. Now, I'm going to talk to you guys a little bit about the UP-41 class project. The UP-41 class project was designed in 1934. So was the Littorio class. But the UP-41 was designed first. It was designed to combat the British and the French, because at this point, they realized that the French would not be their main adversary. It would be the British, because the British had control of the Suez and Gibraltar. So they wanted to design a ship that could easily combat these enemy ships. But they realized that they did not have any 406mm main guns. So they were thinking, what should we do? We still need firepower. So they went with the Littorio class battleship, which was also designed in 1934. The UP-41 was the ship that was supposed to be built. It had secondary guns that were 90mm. It also had the secondary guns that were 152mm. The only difference at this time were the main guns. The ship, during its 1934 design, was supposed to be 40,000 tons. Which, it was that, then after that switched to the Littorio class was known as the 40,000 ton battleship. But that ship easily surpassed 50,000 tons. And it could have easily surpassed 50,000 tons. So, going to the UP-41, the UP-41 had another redesign back in 1937. Now in 1937, it was upgraded from a 40,000 ton battleship to a 45,000 ton battleship, which at that time ignored the stipulations imposed by the Washington Naval Treaty. Now, by this time, Ansaldo already had planned 406mm guns to add to these ships. The problem came when the war started. Italy had to use metals to create the Littorio classes, use the Zara classes, Borzano classes, all that stuff. They also needed steel to go for helmets, guns, tanks, airplanes. So, the Italian Navy could not build this new battleship. Could it have turned the tides of the war? No. This ship could not have turned the tides of the war, especially with how late it was produced. Even if it was produced earlier, let's say that the UP-41 was put into production instead of the Littorio, it still wouldn't have done as much because it doesn't have radar, a little bit inadequate fire control, but even though it had good guns, it still had the reliability issue. It also has another problem of secondary guns, but the 1937 design decided to fix that because instead of having single 90mm guns in each turret, it had dual 90mm guns in each turret. Hence why when you see me building this ship, I will be using dual 90mm guns. You will see that I added 120mm main guns, or 4.7-inch secondary guns. Sorry, not main guns, secondary guns. The reason for that is because if you look at the Littorio class, there were 120mm main gun, secondary guns on the side. Now, the reason for the 120mm guns is still a little bit unknown, but one of the reports that I've read stated that these were used mostly for signaling. I decided to go with a different approach, saying that they were another version of secondary guns that were prototyped. It might have been another gun that they could have used at secondaries, but I couldn't find any other definition except signaling. So, a little bit more about the UP-41 was that it has similar armor schematics to the Littorio class. Its armor was a little bit greater, its design was a little bit larger, but the main look, the main style of it, was pretty much the same. Its only major difference came in the bridge style. So, if you look at the Littorio class, what we have here, it's the only thing that we have. But if we went with the UP-41, it would be a lot more narrow. Anyways, that concludes the UP-41. Let's finish this up.
Now, here is the finalized design for the Giuseppe Verdi from World of Warships. And here is my final design for the Friedrich de Große from World of Warships.
Now, since this is the first video of this series, I'm going to explain the rules really quickly. The rules of this series are quite simple. There are three rounds, one at 5,000 meters, one at 10,000 meters, and one at 20,000 meters. Now, if the game is considered too close, as in if both ships are very heavily damaged, and yet one ship still wins, or it's a draw, we will have one final match at 1,000 meters, as a winner takes all. Now, for the 5,000 meters, it's going to be somewhat of a close-ish engagement, because secondary guns will be in play. At 10,000 meters, it'd be the higher caliber secondary guns and the main guns, whilst at 20,000 meters, it would be strictly main gun combat only, focusing on coordination, focusing on dispersion, and focusing on how much lead you can get downfield. Anyways, let us get started with the first round at 5,000 meters. Post-production soldier here. After round one, we realized that it was a little disappointing. I realized that my ship that I just thought would win actually lost. So we're going to be moving on to round two at 10,000 meters.
Seinen Soldaten allesamt ins Gewehr. 200 Bataillons und an die 1000 Schwadronen und jeder Grenadier kriegt 60 Patronen. 200 Bataillons und an die 1000 Schwadronen und jeder Grenadier kriegt 60 Patronen.
verfluchten Kerch.
Brav seine Majestät,
dass ein jeder in der Partei seinen Mann mir steht. Sie können mir nicht Schlesien und die Grafschaftsplatz und die 100 Millionen in meinem Schatz.
Sie können mir nicht Schlesien und die Grafschaftsplatz und die 100 Millionen in meinem Schatz.
Kaiserin hat sich mit den Franzosen alliiert und das Römische Reich gegen mich revoltiert. Die Russen seid gefallen in Preußen ein. Auch lasst uns zeigen, dass wir brave Landeskinder sein.
Die Russen seid gefallen in Preußen ein. Auch lasst uns zeigen, dass wir brave Landeskinder sein.
Post-production soldier here again. We're just going to move on to round three, to the 20,000 meter. I was very disappointed in this because it looks like the Giuseppe Verdi's not giving a good fight, so let's just move on. Well, that does that for the first video of the series. I expect a little bit more. Anyways, for the next video, we are going to go with the Japanese. I already know what ship's going to be selected, but if you think you do know the ship, please leave a comment down below. And I'm expanding this because I'm still editing the rules as we go. We can go to real ships, but we like to start with fictional ships to see if this series gains any traction. Anyways, if you haven't, please like and subscribe, and I do hope you have a very good day. All right, catch you on the flip side.